All right, here we are, game one between VGJ and Wings Gaming. Get you guys right on into the draft in this game one. Banned out is Cottle as well as Tusk. And then for Wings Gaming, Magnus and Crystal Maiden. And we get into these first two picks. VGJ, they've gone with the Centaur as well as the Monkey King. It's the first time I get to get Monkey King casted under my belt. Probably will be garbage, but it's always great, so let's do well anyway. So Rubick Invoker for Wings Gaming. So we take a look at both these lineups. I expect Monkey King to be in the four spot, Centaur to be in the off lane, and then Rubick obviously mid. Invoker obviously mid, and then Rubick supporting. So we get into these next set of bans. You've got the Centaur on the board. You need to think that Centaur is probably going to be, at least with a Centaur of VGJ, are going to be expecting to go with a Lifestealer if it does make it through. And that really depends on this next ban from Wings. I wouldn't be too surprised to see a ban out here, but they ban the Lina. And let's see. Let's see what VGJ ban out next. Because they have that Centaur, that very standard vehicle in this meta right now for Lifestealer. You infest into the Centaur, you blink, hoofstomp, double edge, and then really, Lifestealer has a very easy job at cleaning it up. But now you've got a Monkey King who's probably going to be in the 4 spot. You've got a long range stun, you've got a good slow from Monkey King, and as the game goes on, a better ult. But, you know, early, good slows, good stuns from Monkey King, and that could help out a Lifestealer in the early game. So let's see what this next ban is from VGJ. And let's see if they do end up picking the Lifestealer, or even if Wings Gaming are forced into picking it to stop it from going the way of VGJ. So they ban out the Nyx. Nyx Abaddon second for VGJ, Warlock and Lina for Wings Gaming in that second phase. So now Wings, they have that third pick. They've got a mid. They've got Rubick. And let's see where Wings want to go from here. Reserve time. You know, Warlock, I mean, Invoker. Wow, I'm all over the place with my names. Invoker, he works well with a solid amount of teams. With Slardar still on the board, maybe we can see a Slardar 4 for Wings Gaming, or even in that offlane role. Sometimes you see when Slardar gets picked up later in the drafts, it's been a trend to have him in the offlane, and then, you know, usually when he's picked up in that first pick, he's usually the 4. So let's see what kind of synergies Wings Gaming are going to be going for as they do pick a Sven. So they're showing their carry early in Sven, which I don't know how much I like against the perspective Lifestealer coming up from VGJ, which I would assume is now the next pick. You know Wings Gaming isn't going to pick it up, and it does do very well for Centaur. That combination, as I said before, is very nice. It's a combination that can get into the face of an Invoker, get into the face of a Rubick or a Sven, and when you're able to get that close and in the face of these heroes thus far for Wings, it could ultimately serve to be a problem. You've got Sven, who he's going to be looking to get himself a Blink, Blink, Stormhammer, God Strength, and clean it up. But you know, how much will he be able to do if we do find that VGJ do pick up a Lifestealer, and if Centaur gets that early blink, could kind of shut down a Sven. Let's see what they go with. 50 seconds remaining on their reserve time. I think we saw a little bit of Monkey King earlier. for the show match that was between Onyx and EG. I'm not sure how that went. I didn't get time to really watch that. I had other things to do, not as important as casting or watching Dota, but it had to happen. So Disruptor gets picked up for VGJ, and I like this pickup. You know, Sven and Invoker, they're not amazing after they've been kited around a little bit. So you know, once they get glimpsed back into Monkey King or Centaur glimpsed into a Hoof Stomp, you know, that's the kind of combination you're looking to work with early with a Disruptor and a Centaur. So still no Lifestealer picked. I still like the idea of a Lifestealer. I've said it before. I explained my entire reasoning for it. 5 seconds. Is it going to be a Lifestealer coming out for VGJ? As Lushrak gets picked up for Winx. I think Lushrak is a 4, Rubick a 5, Sven 1, in that carry role, Invoker mid, so they need an offlaner, I'd presume, 4 wings. VGJ, they need a mid, they need a safe laner, and there it is. Woo! I thought for a second they weren't going to pick it, but there's the Lifestealer, and there everything I spoke about coming out for VGJ. There it is. It lines up. It works out. I don't just explain it for no reason. 10 seconds remaining. So.
5 seconds remaining.
So now Centaur, Monkey King, Disruptor, Lifestealer. I like the combination. They still need a mid. Maybe they're looking for a little bit more mobility. And in that case, they could go mid with a Storm Spirit. A little bit more lockdown. They've only got the stuns of Monkey King and Centaur. Then you've got the lockup of Storm Spirit. And getting into the face again. You know, you can infest in a Storm Spirit, especially when he gets that little bit of farm that he needs to really be effective. Gets that Bloodstone. Lifestealer infests the Storm Spirit instead. And then all of a sudden, you get real up and close into the Sven's face and shut him down. Could be a 4 Sven. Interesting. I like the update.
Remaining.
All right. Possibly going that way. Can't listen to everything from chat. We'll see how it goes. So Tinker gets banned out by Wings Gaming. Last ban from VGJ. We'll have to see what that is and see what VGJ roll with. I do like the Storm Spirit pick for VGJ. We'll see what they end up choosing. As they've already got one vehicle for Lifestealer in that Centaur.
Reserve time.
So they ban out the Batrider, and VGJ, they have the first 5th pick, and it will be a Silencer, so then the Nature's Prophet comes out from Wings Gaming, and we've got ourselves a game. Centaur, Monkey King, Disruptor, Lifestealer, Silencer up against Rubick, Invoker, Sven, Lushrak, and Nature's Prophet. So we'll see how the lineups go. We'll see how the game goes as you guys are here joining me. Game 1 between VGJ and Wings Gaming. This is the first game of a set of 2. So let's see what happens.
Remaining.
So, just waiting for everything to load up. I know they've got the new planning screen ready to go. ROTK on the Centaur, Freeze on the Silencer, Fenrir with the Disruptor Aggressive on the Lifestealer. Don't get to read it all out. Damn it. So close. So immediately the Sunstrike, and that will spot the smoke of VGJ. So ROTK on the Centaur. We take a look over around the horn. Silencer is going to be Freeze Aggressive with the Lifestealer. Disruptor played by Fenrir and Monkey King played by FY on the other side. Wings Gaming, Ice Ice with the Lashrak, Y on the Rubick. Sven going to be played by Shadow, Faith Beyond on the Nature's Prophet, and finally Blink on the Invoker. So we'll see how these lanes really pan out. Is FY already here jumping around? Just up in the trees looking for a nice primal dance, maybe to get themselves first blood. He does spot Faith Beyond, but nobody has come over for the side of VGJ to follow that up. So he's just really scouting out vision right now as Faith Beyond's going to go for this bounty rune up top. 22 seconds until we are underway, and we do see how these lanes kind of progress. So aggressive on the Lifestealer, aggressive on the Lifestealer up top, and then maybe a dual lane down low with ROTK. But Fenrir should be going up top. The glimpse with the open wounds is a solid combination, especially in the early game. So FY ends up getting the bounty rune up here and takes it away from Blink. So three bounty runes go the way of VGJ. And with that, we'll be underway for this game one. Shit, I did it again. Damn, I forgot the overlay again. I'm sorry, that's just angering to me. I shouldn't be that bad. That's the second time tonight. Alright, 2K caster, you guys are right. So, Y and Shadow are down low with the Rubick and Sven. ROTK with the Centaur in the offlane, and coming over is Ice Ice on the Lashrak. Over mid is Freeze up against Blink with the Invoker. And then FY just roaming around with this Monkey King. Meanwhile, up top is going to be Faith Beyond against Aggressive, as well as the Disruptor of Fenrir. All these lanes just sitting pretty even. We'll see how Shadow does in that one spot for the Sven. Four spot was not the way they went. And how quickly we can see this Lifestealer Aggressive get to level 6 and use that Infest for VGJ. We take a look over mid as they're trying to go in on Blink. He's getting very low. Freeze and FY are here. FY actually very low. They do get the first blood out on Blink. And now FY will fall as well. So they get a one-for-one trade, try to get that courier, it gets away with just 11 health. And I'm still frustrated at myself for leaving that overlay. Yeah. There's the reaction showing up. It's the second time tonight, it's just so deflating.
They'll never see me coming.
At least it wasn't up as long this time around. Alright, so let's get back into this as we do see Blink over mid. He was falling for that first blood. Freeze doesn't go down, but it was FY who fell, so it's a 1-1 split for Wings as well as VGJ. And up top, we do take a look at Aggressive. He's 9-1, and not top. He's not in front of this Sven. Shadow is doing a pretty good job looking for those boots. Does have 600 gold under his belt in ROTK. He is now over in this offlane at level 3. So Ice 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 just sitting nearby, looking to maybe push ROTK back with a Diabolic Edict. And ROTK forced to eat that Tango and really try and sit in lane as best he can. And things for Faith Beyond are looking pretty good. He's getting these nice pulls over, getting the farm he can at 9-2. We take a look over back mid as it looks as though FY might be looking to go in on Blink. Coming over is why with this Rubik's... Didn't save the life of Blink last time around, but there it is with the Primal Spring over on Blink. He's getting slowed down quite a bit. Why trying to come over and get the telekinesis, but I'm not too sure it's going to be enough. Here comes the TP over from Faith Beyond. They will be able to get another return kill onto FY. But now they might be able to turn it back around on Faith Beyond. Freeze trying to find a kill with that last word. Now there's the Arcane Curse. Not going to be able to tick enough. So 2-2, still staying even. It's a 1-for-1 trade. Invoker goes down as well as FY again. So again, it's a core Invoker falling, which is Blink. FY, he'll trade his life for it every time. And now maybe they look for something bottom. FY continuing to give the side of VGJ vision. And with ROTK level 3, maybe it's not enough for them to want to go in. FY still sitting in the trees, does see Ice Ice on those Shrek, Shadow pushing on forward. And he will jump further in the trees, just continuing to look out and maybe get another Primal Spring out onto Wings and catch them by surprise, granting them yet another kill. So there it is. There's the Primal Spring. A slow again on Shadow. The Stormhammer comes out on FY. That'll slow him for just a minute. The Warcry with the extra armor keeps him alive. He falls back, and Shadow will survive. He was left alone for just a moment by Ice Ice. And they do try to take advantage of that with the Primal Spring, but they don't end up getting the kill, and FY still showing himself nearby. He gets back up into the trees, and Shadow does see that. He starts to tear away at the trees, trying to spot out FY, but he does jump away again, keeps himself up. Take a look up top at Aggressive, who's over here with the Lifestealer, just about level 6, and then he's up against Faith Beyond as this Nature's Prophet at level 4. And Faith Beyond just trying to get as much farm as he can, sitting kind of far back in terms of CS with a Nature's Prophet, 18-2. As Aggressive, he's found himself 34-12, has the Phase Boots already, going for the Blight Stone. So let's see which direction he goes in. Is it going to be Phase Boots, Armwit, Echo Saber, Desolator? Or is he going to try to go for the Desolator first? And we'll see what he goes next as he finds himself a little bit more farm and I really try to see what builds they can really go with to deal with what will eventually be the split push of Faith Beyond. So we switch it over to net worth, and we do see that Freeze leads the way. Level 5 has himself going for a Midas, and is a bit far away from it. Meanwhile, up top, it's actually going to be Ice Ice falling, but it does end up getting the kill on ROTK. They try to turn it around. FY is here. There's the Stormhammer to finish him off, but in comes the Lifestealer looking for at least one on the return. Why running away? Just with a little bit of health and open wounds would be enough to get the kill, but now Aggressive very deep, and there is the kinetic field. Not going to be enough. The Rage from Aggressive turns around, open wounds out on Y. There's the Global Science, so it'll stop him from getting the telekinesis off. So Aggressive, he's going to have to run out. Shadow does have this Stormhammer if he chooses to use it. There's the Warcry with the Stormhammer, and there's the Split Earth, the Sunstrike to follow it up. Aggressive getting very low, but escapes just by the skin of his teeth with the Infest out on the creek. So he pops out and turns around towards Sven, but that's it. Doesn't go for anything. No open wounds, no attack down on deep, and now Freeze might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Primal Spring to stop Ice Ice for just a moment, and Freeze picked up by the telekinesis as well as hit by the Split Earth. And now FY getting very low, so is Ice Ice. He'll fall, and then will FY. So FY very much trading his life time and time again. And there's the kinetic field out from Fenrir. As I realize, I said that kinetic field just 2 minutes ago on Aggressive was on the same team as him. Wow. When you realize things in retrospect, you really, or at least I do, come down on myself hard. So 5-5, equal on both sides in terms of these kills. Let's take a look over at the net worth split. It should be in favor of VGJ, and it is by just 1,000 net worth. So Shadow gonna end up using that God Strength. He's looking for an armlet. We take a look up top as ROTK has made the move over. He is level 6, does have that Stampede. ROTK looking for something. There's the Diabolic Edict as well as the Split Earth. Faith Beyond gonna get those trees in. ROTK is still trying to run away. There's the Hoof Stomp, but here comes the Telekinesis. The Sunstrike misses due to the Stampede, but Ice Ice will get credit for the kill. Meanwhile, Y in a little bit of trouble, but he gets saved by the trees of Faith Beyond. There's the Rage from Aggressive, still trying to chase down Y, who should have Telekinesis up in just a moment. It's actually 7 seconds, and he will not be able to turn around and get anything out on the Lifestealer. But meanwhile, Fenrir too deep. He gets hit by the stun of Ice Ice, and that Split Earth does land, and they find themselves 2 on Wings Gaming. So 7-5 in favor of Wings Gaming. They take 2. They find themselves back about even in the net worth, and now they will heal up at the Shrine and maybe look to continue forward with this bit of aggression, finding their moment, and there it is, with the smoke. They've got a smoke. They're looking for the Telekinesis as well as the trees and the Split Earth to find somebody out to get the scan, and it's actually from VGJ. So VGJ not going to spot anything with that scan, but now they come on in. There's the Split Earth as well as the Telekinesis. Fade Bolt hits. Global Silence, but that's not going to be enough to save his life. Coming over is FY, and now he's looking for a Primal Spring to go down on 3 of these heroes. It does slow them up just a bit, and FY now has to run away. Ice Ice trying to get out, but there's the Hoof Stomp as well as the Glimpse. They do get the kill on Ice Ice. Aggressive coming over, and Faith Beyond in the trees. Probably going to get spotted, but a good Sprout from Faith Beyond to stop them from being able to get close to him and getting the kill. It will get him enough distance and a successful TP out. Actually down low, there's the last word. It will be popped by the Warcry. Down very low on mana is this Sven, and he has finished off this armlet, so that's where he finds himself a little bit of a power spike. Let's see if Shadow can do anything with this power spike as he's looking for treads next, and I would say ultimately a blink. Could see him actually go for Helm the Dominator, but we'll see what he chooses to do. As smoked up is Y and Ice Ice, they place a deep ward, and smoked up is aggressive and Fenrir, so if they could get vision and get a glimpse back on any on the side of Wings, they should be able to find themselves a kill. Coming in as aggressive as and Fenrir, and now they're trying to get themselves a kill on FY. The Split Earth not going to take out the trees, but there's the Stormhammer out on FY. They do spot him. There's the Telekinesis. They get the kill. And now maybe about facing should be Fenrir and aggressive, but they go in. There's the Static Storm, and they look to take down this Sven. Sven getting very low, and maybe he can armlet toggle, but it's not going to be there. The Split Earth misses. Fenrir will fall. There's the Stampede. They're trying to march on forward. Freeze? Aggressive? No, they won't be able to get the kill. It's 10-7. First to 10 kills goes Wings Gaming's way. And Vici, they lose Fenrir, they lose FY, and they get one on the return, taking out the Sven. So a split almost benefiting Vici J overall. Look over mid. Primal Spring comes out as well as the Sun on Ice Ice. He is surely dead. The Split Earth threw on FY, but that's not going to save his life as the big rotations come out from VGJ. And they find yet another kill now, 10-8. So Gold going aggressive's way. He's found himself phase boots and just a tick off that armlet. Treads come out for Sven. He's going to go for the Echo Saber before the blink, so not a surprise. You like that God Strength Echo Saber hit, and it's really no surprise to see him going for it next. So let's take a look over at ROTK as he's very low on health, going for the Blink Dagger, 400 gold away until we start to possibly see the aggressive move from Aggressive. And maybe a turnaround a bit in this game. We take a look over at the net worth once again. It's even heading towards the way of Wings. But yeah, all of a sudden, you get the initiation of a Blink Hoof Stomp Infest, and things can turn around very quickly. Folk are very poor at the moment. He's picked himself up a Midas, going for the Ags next, pretty standard. And then Shadow, like we said, is going for the Echo Saber. Four staff out for Ice Ice. They spot Aggressive, who's come in a little bit too close. No Stormhammer, as they know he has that Rage. They'll take out the Tier 1. There's the Rage, and now with the Open Wounds, they get the stun as well as the ulti coming from FY, as well as the Global Silence. That'll be enough to get themselves a kill. They get the glimpse on Ice Ice, sends them all the way back. That's not going to help you survive. You're not getting out of that. There's the Telekinesis. Sunstrike off the mark as he threw him back. And two die on the side of Wings, and they're looking for more, but the Sprout will stop it for just a moment. There's the Quelling Blade, and now they look to get a kill on Faith Beyond. No Glimpse, not enough mana for it, and he'll be able to TP out.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Oh, take a look over mid. ROTK getting very low. The Infest was there for why? And they end up using the Infest to their own benefit, getting themselves a kill on the Centaur, now 11-10. Yeah, helm's not as great as it once was, but we take a look over. FY, he's been spotted out. There's the Split Earth and the stun stolen by Y. So now he's got that level 3 Boundless Strike. Let's see, another good ability stolen by Y. He took the Infest, they used it well with the TP of the Nature's Prophet going in on ROTK and granting themselves a nice kill. And now he's got the Boundless Strike, and that's a long-range strike that maybe the Sven is hoping to use to his advantage. Get that God Strength as well as a Stormhammer, and they might be able to find themselves a quick kill. So we take a look over at, wow, voice crack galore. We take a look over at VGJ. They do have the Blink Dagger out on ROTK, so let's see if they start using it to their advantage. As Aggressive, he's going for an SNY. Not going to go for the Echo Saber or the Desolator just yet, choosing to go for the SNY. But let's see if they start using the Infest Blink play to their advantage, and they haven't used it yet. It's actually been used by Wings more than it's been used by VGJ overall. So God's Strength is popped. They're looking to finish off this Echo Saber on Shadow, which is a nice damage dealer when all things are considered. And meanwhile, FY is going to spot out Ice Ice, so they get the ping, and with the tower still up, they can't really dive on him. So Ice Ice just going to move forward. Put himself in harm's way, but nobody following it up from VGJ. They do spot out Blink. And Blink working towards that Ags. Only two items away, 2,000 gold. And to me, FY, it's a substitution, really, to a nice Ricky. Meanwhile, we get the Blink with the Hoof Stomp. There's the Open Wounds out on Ice Ice. He's getting very low. They're trying to still come through. Ice Ice still surviving. The Boundless Strike out on two. Here comes the ulti from the Monkey King, but they've already lost ROTK. They get the Kinetic Field out on Y. He'll fall as he's under the Static Storm, and now there's the Glimpse back on Faith Beyond. Can he survive long enough to TP out? And he will. So no Boundless Strike there for FY. With that, Faith Beyond will be able to TP out. So what I was saying is really, it's not a poor man's or a rich man's Ricky. It's just, it seems to be a replacement for Ricky, where he can find you that optimal intelligence with the vision. But of course, you know, without items, he's not too strong, but he also at the same time still has that long range stun, as well as a nice slow. So, again, still going for the SNY is this Lifestealer. And Freeze, he's got that Midas, now a 4-staff, and he's looking just for Boots of Travel. Over mid, we see four from wings. Shadow, Y, Blink, Ice Ice. And now Faith Beyond as they look to push. They will use that war cry. They will use the God Strength, immediately forcing out the glyph from VGJ. I don't think this will be enough to really hold this tower. They've got the Diabolic Edict pushing it as well, and that's an easy tower going the way of wings. And no rotation from VGJ at all. Take a look down low as they try to rotate and defend this tower. They get the Chaos Meteor out, and pushing it back is Blink, so... Let's take a look. 2,000 net worth lead for Wings. Because now they lose a top tier 1 to Aggressive. Coming over is Shadow. The Sprout not there. There's the Rage. He's going to try and TP out. But the Rage and the TP were a little bit too spread apart. No. Be able to TP out just with ease. So Desolator now picked up for the Lifestealer. He's infested in FY, and I was talking about how Centaur would be that vehicle for Lifestealer, but I failed to think about the FY possibilities with the Monkey King. Monkey King, he has the ability to get that vision from atop the trees, jump down with the Primal Spring, and then pop the Infest from there. Question is, how much time are you willing to take with the Lifestealer in FY before you really just have to ditch the efforts? The tier 1 still stands mid, and there you are going to spot Y. There's the Blink with the Hoof Stomp. The Infest is popped. They do get the kill. Goes the way of Aggressive. And he finds himself yet another as he's dominating now 4-0. So they want to head up top. The Static Storm out on Ice Ice. He's under the Kinetic Field, but nobody to follow it up just yet. There's the Stampede coming over his FY as well as Aggressive. The Split Earth not going to be enough to get himself a kill, and he'll fall here too as Wings lose 2. Sunstrike not going to be enough to take out Fenrir and backing off his Wings. So Blink has finished off that Ags. We saw him very low on the net worth early on, and he's now surpassed Faith Beyond on the Nature's Prophet, and he's starting to creep up on Aggressive. He had this not good start, and he's starting to pull it back. They've given him enough time. He has that recovery Midas. I mean, obviously Midas is pretty standard, but now there's the Boundless Strike. They're trying to get the Blink in with the Hoof Stomp. They will get it with the Infest, the ulti used by FY, but honestly not even needed. Meanwhile, Faith Beyond gets himself a kill with the ult. So FY falls, and they do end up losing Invoker, so I'm just talking about how he's starting to pull himself back in, and right as he attempts to, that's it, he's dead. So a one-for-one trade going the way of VGJ beneficially. And they start to pull this net worth back from a 2,000 deficit more towards even. So smoked up his Wings, Shadow, Y, and Ice Ice trying to find something. And freestanding mid, there's the Force Staff with the Stormhammer. He gets a stun on two, but now Boundless Strike follows that up. The Split Earth with the Sprout. They will be able to find a kill on Fenrir. And with the Global Silence already used, they back up the Primal Spring. It's out on this Fen. Not too sure that's the right move, is now why he's got that Kinetic Field. The Stormhammer, the Sunstrike, there it is. Blink Hoof Stomp. They try to turn it around on this Rubick. They will lose FY. And going down is Y. So now Ice Ice surrounded on all sides. He'll be the next one to fall, minus two. And Shadow in a lot of trouble. He'll fall. It's a triple kill for Freeze. Still moving forward is ROTK, looking for the Hoof Stomp. He'll find it. Open wounds. Freeze is here. Minus two again. And Freeze with a huge ultra kill for VGJ. So VGJ, they get a huge turnaround, and Freeze, he's got that Hurricane Pike, Boots of Travel, now going for the Rod of Atos. With a huge win like that, they swing the net worth in their favor, XP at the 6,000 mark, and Wings, when they once looked to have control of this game, it's kind of fizzled out, as now with the Blink Dagger on ROTK, the Infest pops that they're getting, it has just not been good for them. So the Telekinesis is there from onto ROTK, as well as the Tornado coming through his Shadow. There's the Storm Hammer, and it will hit ROTK, but he gets himself forward from the Force Staff from Freeze. It's not going to be enough to get him out. Shadow gets the kill, but now he's under the Static Storm. There's the Sunstrike out on Fenrir, and going down again is Shadow. They will buy back on ROTK, possibly for the ult, but with Wings retreating, maybe the buyback a bit too soon. So with that, VGJ can push forward. They now have 5 due to the buyback of ROTK. And they do have Stampede if they look to push even further and maybe be a bit more aggressive. Meanwhile, down low, FY found himself a little bit of trouble. There's the Split Earth. Should be FY going down, and it will. Ice Ice gets the kill, and Invoker does end up denying the tower. We take a look at Faith Beyond, looking for a Dragonlance and a Hurricane Pike of his own, trying to split push as well as he can. Meanwhile, we take a look over Nature's Prophet right into the hands of ROTK, but he doesn't go in yet, knowing that that Invis is up and he'll blink out. So coming over is Shadow to get this Roche under the noses of VGJ. Let's see if they realize it, if they start to head over. They don't spot Shadow. There's a big smoke. They start to make the rotation over. They do sense something's up, and Shadow not doing a very good job at getting this Roche. He's down to about half health. If they do choose to go in, they might be able to find themselves a kill. The scan's out, so they know the smoke's there. There's the blink in with the possible hoof stomp, but ROTK has found the nothing. ROTK gets hit by that tornado, the EMP too far back, and both teams will separate and maybe look to reset and go back into this Roche, leaving it at half. So while all this is happening, now Shadow's put himself up top. Freeze nowhere near the fight. He's down low, just continuing to push. Let's take a look at Faith Beyond. Justin still has that Hurricane Pike. I'm surprised maybe that he wasn't split pushing as all that was happening. So FY still just trying to grant vision for his team. Sitting near and true is aggressive. And up top is ROTK, so they can get that infest as well as the blink hoof stomp if Wings Gaming try to go for that Roche again. So pushing bottom now is Faith Beyond. FY still sitting by Roche. And just farming up more and more as VGJ, as they finally have that Sanjin Yasha out on Lifestealer with the Desolator. Gets spotted out by the nice Forge Spirit. And they know that VGJ are waiting nearby. So taking out the vision, VGJ trying to make their position well known to this Roche. Know that they're trying to set up and get themselves an Aegis, but meanwhile, down low, Faith Beyond is going to continue to push. Arcane Curse, not enough to take out all these Treants, and the Tier 2 down past half health. Aggressive will come over and just farm away. And looking with that Sprout is Faith Beyond to try and find himself a kill. There's the Split Earth, but off the mark of Faith Beyond. Now coming over with the Storm Hammer is Shadow. He gets hit with those open wounds. There's the God Strength. Maybe he turns it around and aggressive. There's the Arcane Curse. And hitting away is Freeze. Shadow might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Boundless Strike coming in from FY. Enough to get the kill on Shadow. And now they try to turn it around, but TPing out is the Rubik. Aggressive with another. And now they TP to the Shrine as they get the Blink. Hoof Stomp Double Edge, but not going to hit on anybody. So, VGJ, they get a huge kill on the Sven, And now they look for even more, and Mawai, he's a bit far forward. Aggressive's going to have to use that rage as well as the open wounds. Open wounds now picked up by the Rubick. Let's see if they can use that to their advantage. But still no Roche play from either side. I thought maybe with that Sven kill, Vici J would go ahead towards Roche, knowing that maybe they're not in that much trouble. And there's the Sunstrike to check. So FY just sitting nearby. Blink and Y are spotted. Now the Rod of Atos out on freeze. So he's hitting pretty hard. He's level 19. And he sits top of the net worth. Followed by the Lifestealer next, who's got himself that Desolator SNY armlet. Looking for the AC for his next item. He will sit infested in ROTK, possibly noting that they might be looking to make a move. They are continuing to sit towards this top shrine and jungle area near Roche just to make sure it doesn't get taken. And there's a Sunstrike to try and scout it out. But they still also have creeps, which will spot everything there too. Again, Wings Gaming, they'll retreat from this tier 2 down low, almost dead. ROTK nearby does have the Stampede as well as a Blink if they tried to get real in onto Wings Gaming, but they let them back off, they let them TP out, and now again, Wings, they're looking for the Roche. Ice Ice is in the pit, everybody Delta maneuvers out, and Fenrir comes through with the Kinetic Field, ROTK nearby. Take a look, there's the Glimpse back with the Hoof Stomp and the Infest. Faith Beyond will fall. So now without this Nature's Prophet, VGJ are the ones who make their way into the pit. And without the Nature's Prophet, they might not have a play at this, but they will force the buyback. There's the Sunstrike. They're going to scout it out, try and time it up. The Sprout is here. Shadow is invis with the Shadow Blade, and there's the Global Silence. That'll lock it up. They get the Aegis out on Aggressive with the Boundless Strike coming on through. There's on two with the Blink from ROTK and the Hoof Stomp. They're trying to make something happen. The ulti thrown from Faith Beyond, but not going to get them a kill. Split Earth comes through. It'll pop the Aegis immediately of Aggressive on this Lifestealer. And now Telekinesis to the high ground, but they still get the kill on Ice Ice. There's the Glimpse back on Y. He'll be another victim of the onslaught of VGJ. It's a triple kill for Freeze. Four fall on Wings, while they only lose the Aegis from VGJ. So with that, the bottom tier 2 will be pushed from Faith Beyond. He continues to try and split push, but the lead is extending for VGJ, and it is not as much as I thought it would be, but heading towards 3,000 to 4,000. And you take a look, it's 3,000 to 4,000 on the net worth, but about 12,500 on the experience. So VGJ very far ahead in terms of levels, but net worth wise, they are still pretty close and even. So let's take a look over at Freeze looking for the Lincoln Sphere. Has the Rod of Atos, Hurricane Pike hitting like a truck at this moment in time, really cleaning up at 11-1-7. That's the opposite of 7-11, and we know what that means. Nothing. Because I'm not sponsored by them. So ROTK with some nice wave clear with the double edge, especially with the Hood of Defiance, really doesn't take much damage back at him. He's got the Ags for the Stampede, which was nerfed just a bit, right? So side of VGJ, they'll continue to push out, and it's hard for really Faith Beyond to push the other way with his team behind. He's trying to do what he can as he TPs up top. They're not going to find anything. These are illusions. Coming over is Shadow. He's got that Shadow Blade, but they haven't been able to find anything on VGJ as Shadow just wasting it. And four up here from Wings Gaming is maybe not the right move, as down low is the side of VGJ grabbing themselves a tier 2 in this bottom lane. So there's the Infest out on Freeze. They'll TP up top. Four still here for Wings Gaming, so they got to be very careful. Faith Beyond going to TP down bottom to clear up this creep wave. And coming from the back end is Fenrir and ROTK. They get the scan out from the Dire. VGJ know where Blink is, and they're starting to come on through. There's the Blink with the Hoofstomp, Static Storm, as well as the Kinetic Field. They're going to start to work on this Invoker. Let's see if they can get the kill. There's the Boundless Strike from FY to finish him off. So FY gets the kill earlier on. We were seeing Monkey King give up his life for kills, and now he's the one cleaning him up. So he's got himself Phase Boots, he's got the Basher for that ult, and now he's going for that Echo Saver as he starts to get items and becomes a bit more effective for VGJ. So Shadow, he'll finish off the BKB, which in my opinion really is what Wings need to kind of be successful in a team fight. They need to keep this Sven alive, and without a BKB, it's a hard time getting that done. But now with it, let's see what Wings do. Shadow gonna continue to push bottom. Meanwhile, up top, the creeps are coming in towards the Wings base and towards this tier two, which it looks as though VGJ will get. Shadow continuing to push. He's got these creeps to this bottom tier three, and TPing in his ROTK with the Infest. Should be able to clean up easy with the double edge as well as the damage he outputs right now. So ROTK still infested. He's looking for that next big item with Lifestealer still in him. Well, Lifestealer now picks up this AC, so a big item for VGJ, and ROTK and Lifestealer together, Aggressif, they are one hell of a duo. You don't see Aggressif on the map. You got to assume that he's infested in someone such as the Centaur, so they're going to keep away from him knowing that he's bottom. So the split push is pretty good for Wings. They've got the Nature's Prophet, they've got the cleave damage of Shadow, so they can push out these creep waves and make it ultimately harder for VGJ to really push forward into these tier 3s. But again, Wings need to find themselves a good fight with these creep waves pushed out. And one fight going their way could turn into at least a tier 3. Both teams continuing to just sit back, farm away. Faith Beyond continuing to do so. He looks as though he's going for that Bloodthorn for the Orchid first. Blink over with this BKB, Blink and Ags. And he'll be going for the Shiva's Guard next. So again, FY just trying to scout out with some vision. There are three bottom four Wings Gaming. And none of them smoked up just yet, just a ghost walk coming out from Blink. So Freeze up top has finished off that Lincoln Sphere. So he's going to be a very hard target to kill for Wings Gaming. And on top of that, they do have the Centaur, who's a tank in himself. So VGJ, they definitely have the leg up right now, up 10,000 net worth, looking towards tier 3s. But again, one team fight can change this game. We've seen a 10k net worth already tonight get vanquished. They didn't end up winning that game, but it was still went the way of the other team after just a little moment longer. So EMP comes out, as well as the Cold Snap. ROTK going to get infested again and look to reset, regroup, and look for the tier 3 one more time. So there it is, Blink, Hoofstomp, Infest, Papa, not on anybody. There's the ulti used by FY. Shadow is invis, and they will end up getting that tier 3 for VGJ. They use it just to back off the side of Wings. It does successfully do its job, granting them this nice tier 3. and now opening up those shrines. And the shrines will be exactly what they go for. They pick it up, 150 gold goes their way, and they start working towards these next items. Back infested into ROTK is aggressive. Let's take a look up top. Faith Beyond is trying to farm as much as he can. Doesn't have himself that orchid. There's the stampede on forward. They do get the glimpse as well as the kinetic field, but it's not going to land. There's the Rod of Atos as well as the static storm thrown from Fenrir. The boundless strike from FY. And it is Freeze, who's now godlike and gets yet another kill. So Freeze 12-1-7. Doing an amazing job as this silencer ended up going mid and has been having quite the game, as you could tell by his net worth and by his items. He's 7,000 net worth up on the Lifestealer, 8,000 net worth up on the Invoker, and really at this point, pretty close to unstoppable. So VGJ, they'll finish off this second and last shrine for Wings Gaming. And Roche back up in 53 seconds with that shrine going down. They have complete control of this top area in the river as well as by this secret shop. Can't risk going out there. You can't TP in if you try to make a move on Roche. So VGJ very comfortable right now with the lead they have. And that lead is 15,000 net worth and 30,000 experience. But meanwhile, bottom, they're looking for the split push. Trying to get this tier 3, and they're doing a pretty good job at it with the Forge Spirits and the Treants. So the tower gets very low, sitting at 143. There's a tornado in. Gonna stop ROTK, who's infested up. There's a stampede on forward. They're looking for a kill on the retreat, but VGJ, they'll get nothing. So the split push becoming a nuisance, a thorn in the side of VGJ. And as time goes by and Nature's Prophet becomes stronger with the Forge Spirits as well as the Sven, it'll become just more and more of a problem that VGJ eventually have to deal with. So there's the boots travel in. They do spot Faith Beyond. They're going to come in on this. There's the blink with the hoof stomp. They get a kill. Meanwhile, Fenrir will fall off screen. And now let's see if Wings continue to go in. They pop their BKBs. Going in is blink. They get the deafening blast out on Freeze. He'll fall. He's now dead. It's a 10-kill streak wiped off the map. And now ROTK, he's getting pretty low as the BKB's there from Shadow. We get a little bit of slideshow gaming, and he'll be taken out. So four fall on the side of Wings. Getting away will be why, but it all turns around as the ulti comes through from Monkey King FY. They clean it up with Aggressive as well as ROTK. Four fall on Wings, and let's take a look. It's a pretty even split in terms of net worth after that 10 kill streak taken out on Freeze. So they do lose four. They're even in gold, but after losing four, it opens up the push for VGJ. They actually get the buyback. Split Earth, it hits on Aggressive. He might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the blink hoof stomp from Y, but the rage is forced out. And he will infest back into ROTK. So there's his taxi. He's got to go. So Roche back up, should be all VGJ. Don't think Wings are going to be looking to make a move. They know that it's a hard fight for them to take. And it's a quick Roche nonetheless. It's something hard for really Wings to contest at all. They got to push out these lanes as much as they can, push these creep waves back so their base is in as much of trouble as it would be if they went to go after that Roche and didn't push back these creep waves. So they're going to continue to push with Ice Ice looking for that tier 3. And now there's the Hex out on Ice Ice, but now coming in is Y. They get the Fade Bolt, and here comes the Stampede coming through as ROTK. There's the Static Storm out on Y. He'll fall, drop the gem. And they'll also lose Ice Ice, but now here's the glimpse onto Faith Beyond. He's locked up and dead, and Freeze gets another double kill. And wow, VGJ played that just perfectly. So three dead again on the side of Wings. VGJ, top three net worth leaders are all on their side. It's Silencer, Lifestealer, and then the Centaur. It's Freeze, Aggressive, and then ROTK. They do take out the tier three mid as well as the Rax. And now they head over top to continue on fourth. And they'll get that tier three. There's the Stormhammer, ROTK. He's a hard hero to kill, and there's the Split Earth to go on him still. But really, Shadow, they're looking at a hero who's just a tough sell. There's the Rod of Atos, another kill, minus two. Fenrir gets credit for that one. They're without Ice for 48 more seconds. They'll lose another set of racks. Stormhammer again on ROTK, the tankiest of the heroes. And with that, Wings will just go ahead and call GG. Well, get a kill on Shadow there too. And a courier, we're handing out items all over the place. And VGJ, they'll take game one of this best of two. So, more overlay problems consist on through to the second series. But other than that, it felt pretty good. VGJ, they do very well. They control this game. Once they get the Blink Dagger out on that Centaur, they feel their aggression. They feel their moment and pushed all the way towards this win. They live and continue on fourth for this 1-0 lead thus far. And they'll head into game two, looking to take a 2-0 sweep here at DPL Season 3. I'm your caster at BCOP92, always looking for criticism. So, you know, send me tweets, tell me what you think. Yes, I know, overlay, and really anything else would be nice. So we'll be back in just a moment with Game 2. Enjoy some music as we get ready in the lobby.